let's do this thing.
Yeah. Before we go to the Duke, first question. Are they taking my gem, which is my lucky charm?
No, it's not a weapon.
Cool. And second thing, I tell them I expect some kind of signal that they succeeded by nightfall. Well, by the next day.
Yeah.
If not, I'm gonna take things into my own hands.
Okay. So, a bunch of these cloaked figures actually approach this little sewer campsite. There are four others that come out of the darkness. And, yeah, Hagor, he signals to them to, like, form up with you all. Okay. There's something that I would say would happen, but it may depend on Raveld.
Okay.
I would say that at some time Hagor takes Raveld away from everybody. But, I mean, not Raveld. Hagor takes Elman away from everybody. But, Raveld, how on a mission are you? Are you...
As long as I can see... I wouldn't let him get out of my sight. If they're going to whisper, that's fine, because I don't think he's going to, like, make him run off, because this helps them, too.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't take eyes off.
Okay. Well, then this happens, Elman, at some point while you all are camping. It's just, he's just far enough away that you don't hear him speaking to him, right?
Sure.
And he doesn't have his cloak, like, pulled up, like, yes, let us make devious plans. But I think that's when you give him that exchange. I think that's when you give him that exchange, Elman, about, like, you expect a signal. And it's really quick, right? He just puts his hand on your shoulder and he says, you will have the signal before we leave the Duke's presence.
Very well. I do hope you succeed. I would love to see your city again.
Yeah.
This time from the inside.
He says, it is doubtless.
I'm sure.
So...
Man, this is going to be so bad.
so you all head into the city.
Justin, am I allowed to consult my people?
Do you have any way to contact them at a distance?
No, I was just... Well, actually, yes, I do.
Contact plane.
It's like your one spell.
No, actually, I have an item for it.
Oh, you have a cell phone?
I don't really want to do it because it's really dangerous to use. Actually, I can't remember. I think it's dangerous. It's pretty bad.
Is it a Note S7?
Yeah,
basically, yes.
God damn it.
A tear. I can't remember what happened.
Does it light one of your companions on fire?
Yeah, I don't think you...
What is this that you have?
The crystalline tear.
Oh!
The crystalline tear?
Basically, it's kind of like the awakened bindwork and project myself.
Yeah, so the issue... The issue is that they wouldn't want to let you guys leave the camp, right? You keep eyes on us, we keep eyes on you. Right? We all need to stay as a group until this thing is done. For everybody's, like, security, right? But, if you were like, fine, Scryden, in order to preserve my manliness, I must have a nap. And then if you use the death god's tear to project astrally project yourself.
What could go wrong?
You could definitely do that. That could be awesome.
Ah, fuck, I'm gonna do it anyway. It looks fun. I can't die, I don't think, but it can be very bad. Okay, cool. Yeah, I wanna do that.
You are a fool, right?
Take me like 2 seconds. Sorry, guys.
No, he's not. No. He thinks slightly too high.
He's probably a fool. But
so, he could be, yeah. So those who gaze into the depths of the crystal without breaking away, this takes a few minutes at least, find their souls pulled from their bodies. After a few moments of confusion, witnessing cosmic visions that assault their mind, they come to, sitting in place opposite their own body, that still holds and stares into the crystal. So Scryden, you get yourself a little bit of privacy, and you stare deep into the crystal. And as you stare deep into it, your vision kind of becomes a tunnel. And the greenness of the crystal becomes everything that you see. And deep in the crystal, you start to see shimmering and scintillating shapes. They appear first as strings, as strands that start to fill your visions. Strands of light, as if blowing in a breeze, like a spider web, or a spider's web that's been torn, and flows around you, but then they start to take on a different sort of character, as if they have a life, as if something is controlling these many different strands disconnected. Okay, roll it. That's the cosmic vision.
It's really cool. I do this more often, but I have a feeling. Yeah, that's
what I thought. Well, all right.
So on a miss, you hold one, but you will be reduced to 1 HP and exhausted upon returning to your body. So this, you feel the life being drained out of you. Your heartbeat pounds in your chest. Feels like it's going to explode. And you may spend your hold one for one to do any of the following while in spirit form. Appear instantly somewhere you can name. Take a semi-physical form for a moment to appear, interact, or attack with weapons or spells, the physical world. Take control of another body for a short time. If you stay too long or the creature dies while you inhabit it, you will be sent violently back to your body with 1 HP and be exhausted. Or appear back in your body in the same condition as you left it. That last one obviously isn't a choice anymore, but... Yeah, otherwise... Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I just want to appear in the thing.
Okay.
Well, can they see me?
Actually, you probably have to fly there and then use your hold to appear as a physical form in order for them to interact with you. But, yeah, you go to the tavern where your entourage is waiting. And they've got drinks and food around. They're spending your money. And, and they are definitely gossiping because that's their drawback. They're talking about, oh yes, down in the sewers. There's some people gathered around that they're trying to bragging to, right? And yeah, they're talking about where you've gone, where we last left you, strange people down in the sewers, that kind of thing. So what do?
Yeah, I appear before them. Silence! I put my hands on the table. Right. Now is the time that we must focus. There's a great threat beneath us. He is he said his name, right? They said the Skinner?
The Skinner, yeah.
Yeah.
His name is the Skinner, and I need to know everything about the Skinner. Everything you know.
Oh, okay.
Consult the books.
Yeah. Yeah, and they're like, everybody is turned around in confusion. But they hop too. They say, the Skinner, yes! The books! And they start to grab books off and start reading them there in the bar. So they're going to consult their texts of history and magic. What is it you're trying to know about the Skinner or learn about the Skinner?
I'm trying to know... well... Probably something... What's his angle? Like, what does he want?
Okay. Yeah, go ahead and spout lore. And you can definitely use your entourage.
So much work for one spout lore.
So it's a plus one for their learning.
Plus one, yeah.
Yeah.
You know everything.
Sure. They, yeah, one of them pipes up and says, oh yes, the Skinner, once known by a different name, though that name has been lost to time. The Skinner is a servant of a greater power. An ancient god priest. That's the translation from a word, that he is both priest and considered a god. Yeah, I mean, you got a 15. So, but long ago he was killed or died, it's not clear what exactly happened. But they seek to resurrect his body. And it requires souls. There is an ancient necromantic rite that will bring this being back to life. This being is known to have untold power, to have lived many eons ago. His soul is indestructible. It shall never pass beyond the gates of death, but shall only wait for resurrection. Every millennia.
That's fucked up.
And his name is Zaltotun.
Oh, God. I don't want to deal with him.
That would be... That is the Skinner's geesh in life. In unlife.
Hmm.
So, I guess it's at that phrase, that sort of word of power. That... The utterance, the realization, in your spirit form, something sort of like ripples and sort of grabs at your soul. And you hear a high-pitched sound and then sort of a piercing noise, like a string wound tight being snapped. And you... appear back in your body suddenly, and it's as if you haven't been breathing all the while, and you gasp for air and wheeze for a moment, pale, and that name, Zaltotun, ringing in your ears.
Yeah, so I probably like grasp the gem, right? I'm like, and I think I'm gonna tell like everyone what just happened. Everyone, I don't even care.
Okay.
I hope they're all standing by the fire, and I'm like, I have something to tell you.
Bad dream, huh?
I've seen things.
Yeah. You tell us all of that, huh?
Oh, yeah. My boys found something.
What? Is this guy Zoltatoon? Is he such a big deal that I would have heard of him, or would people have to fill my character in on what the significance is of that?
I mean, Betlick got a lot of detail.
Okay.
It's probably as much detail as anybody would have based on, like, any sort of history book, because...
They have all the books.
Well, yeah, they have all the books, and, their books are huge.
No.
The best books.
Bigly. And but the thing is that Zoltatoon existed before history, right?
Oh.
Before time. If there is a book anywhere that is about that person or their life, he probably wrote it, right? And nobody has hold of that.
Okay. So Firewatch was built by near Zeltatoon's tower as sort of to keep eyes on it. So I guess that name holds importance for me.
For sure.
Yeah, damn. Okay. And I still don't fully know what happened at the Battle of Firewatch, to be honest. Is that town even still there?
If it is, it's not in the state it was before.
Right. Yeah, so Firewatch for you, Chris, is currently it's the only like holy city for us Rickard followers. That's on the map anyway. yeah. Okay. So yeah, I guess like rumors have been spreading like big war blah blah blah. Anyway. I guess, yeah, I'll look at Hagor and just, if that's the case, we should get moving it, like, now. Is it, there's no way for me to tell what, time it is down here, but,
right.
Surely, moving through even a little bit of sunlight shouldn't be too bad, right?
Yeah.
I'm, like, I'm obviously anxious.
Yeah, I mean, he says something weird, like, he says, well, another 45 minutes should be fine. I think they have, like an almost supernatural circadian rhythm, right? Because they live so far underground, how do they tell days, right?
Right.
He just can. But there's a little bit of more time passes, and you all...
Now, I have a patron with... one of its features being many otherworldly rivals.
Okay.
When I hear the name, do I get anything? Some feedback?
No, not particularly.
Okay. Making sure.
There is one. Okay.
Okay.
I want us to get us moving to what's his face, but. If we have 45 minutes, and we have this little, if we have this little fire, I think at the utterance of Zoltatoon is like the perfect time for me to put myself on a quest.
Dennis, Be careful.
I know. It's gonna be bad. I know. These guys are gonna do horrible, evil things when we get up there.
I mean, play your character, play honest, but like, it would be a cool quest if one of the quests that you could put yourself on right now, but it could also be a forever quest. So,
right.
Yeah. Maybe think about priorities, but definitely go ahead and set yourself on fire and let's see what happens.
Sure. Okay. Yeah. Man. Okay. I'll be careful with the wording, maybe. Okay. So yeah, I guess like oh, another 45 minutes, and like I kind of sit down and stare into this fire, kind of just wide-eyed and unblinking. And sort of nod to myself and like rummage through my bag, and I take out this like thing of holy oils, uncork it and kind of spritz some on my fingers and stuff, and like flick oil into the fire, and so it sparks and burns up a bit as like I'm like muttering some sort of like, it's almost like a chant or something, like some sort of like army marching chant or something, that sort of cadence, as I'm like flicking oil in it. And so okay, I'm not going to say slay, and I'm not going to say I want to defend. Well, this is going to suck too, I think, because they're going to do a bunch of evil things upstairs. But I want to defend the deep ones from the machinations of the Skinner.
Okay. So this is the prayer, right? You're throwing the fire. Are you setting yourself on fire again?
I'm going to at the end. I'm going through. I'm going to go through steps.
I'm going to at the end.
Yeah, I'm going to. So, but yeah, like the part of the chant here is like what I'm at, like basically like what I'm setting out to do, right?
Okay.
So yeah, defend the deep ones from the Skinner's nations. Yeah, so once that's done, right, I've done enough of the flicking stuff, and like it's like roaring and spinning everywhere, and maybe if everyone's like taking some steps back, it's getting just fire. Yeah. We could choose two. So okay. Divine Authority is cool, but I don't know if I want that. Sons of Pierce Lies, Voice and... Voice that transcends language. Well, no. That could be useful with deep ones, but... No, I'll just use... Alright, I'll just... Yeah, I like that mark of Divine Authority too much, I think. Okay. And, invulnerability to... Well, like, I can't just say, like, death magic, right?
Necromancy.
Can I say necromancy or death magic? One of those, like...
yeah. Yeah, you could say necromancy.
All right.
I could be down with necromancy.
Sure. So, yeah. And I want invulnerability to necromancy. So, what I do then... I take this oil thing and I upend it and I like dump it down my arms, and I'm probably gonna do more, yeah, because I want to be immune to fucking death magic. I need the arms, like, yeah, down the arms, and I probably like douse my legs too. So I oil up, and then I step into this fire. I just walk on top of it. Yeah.
Are we all there?
Oh yeah, I guess so. Yeah. It hurts a lot. I'm screaming. There's a point again. Like I loved how Amber described it, where it's like it's a moment of heat. It's like fine, and then it gets a little too hot, and then it's just screaming. As it just shoots up me.
I will ask Gryden. Do we need to help him?
Gryden looks fucking horrified, right?
Everybody does. Maybe Elman doesn't. He's dead inside.
There's no help for a man like us.
There's no help for a man like us.
Maybe Hollis. Maybe Hollis, like, yanks me out. Like, what the fuck are you doing? One of my many hirelings. I hit the ground, like, on fire, and, like, I think, yeah, it's like he yanks me out and throws me in the sewer water.
Okay.
Yeah.
Maybe a bad plan.
Maybe a bad plan. Whatever. Something to put the fire out. Whatever.
If we have blankets, Moggle try to help once someone else has intervened. If we can try to put out the fire.
Holy crap. Yeah, you lit yourself on fire just now.
Did.
But
I'm immune to death magic now.
Should have made yourself immune to fire.
No, I need to feel the pain.
what other boon are you taking?
So
Mark of Divine Authority.
Mark of Divine Authority. Why?
So
weird.
So you're like burning, and
yeah,
they grab you and they toss you in some water, some murky water nearby.
Yeah.
And they dunk you under. So all the fire goes out. I mean, it's an oil fire you set on yourself. So,
yes.
The water makes it dangerous for them to put it out.
Right.
So I think they try that, and then... Mog, you said you want to try and, like, help?
Well, like, I was like a blanket? Like... smother it with, like, if we have blankets or cloth of any sort.
Yeah, so they start to, they toss him in the water, and like the oil starts to come off and just like lights on fire at the top, right? And there's just like it explodes in their faces as they pull him back out, and you come over with blankets, like beating him to put him out again. Mog, go ahead and son of a
by danger plus
let's do this. Roll to aid revolt.
Okay. So I have one bond with him. Do I get his bonds with me or just one way?
Yeah, just the ones you have with him.
Alright. 8.
Okay. Right. Well, that means that if I get a 7 to 9 here on whatever I'm rolling, you're gonna be in danger too.
Well, it's gonna put him in a spot no matter what.
Oh yeah, sure.
So Hollis the Protector is coming over to help also. Okay, Raveled. Defy danger with your constitution.
I will. I will do that thing. And I get a plus one, so. Boom.
Nice. Ooh,
yeah.
What even is a horrible oil fire?
So. Yeah. Roll a d6.
Sure. 3.
Okay.
3 layers of skin. That's that's how many you lose.
It's a third degree burn.
Yeah.
Don't even imagine if you rolled a 6.
I'm just a skeleton now.
Just dust.
But immune to death magic.
But I'm immune. Can be revived.
Can't be revived.
Dust can be revived.
Mog, I'm going to give you the option here.
Okay.
You can, since you rolled a 7 to 9, Ravolt's going to be as okay as he is, but you, like, you're slapping the grease fire and stuff, and there's fire everywhere, so I'm going to let you get a choice. You can either have Hollis take more of the damage because she was trying to dunk him in water first, and then you came in and saved, or you could get in there and take these 3 points of damage on yourself.
I'm heroic. I'll take 3 points of damage.
Okay. It ignores your armor, but you are burnt.
Okay, let me have this character sheet up somewhere. And then I just, all right, I'm looking for the HP on this.
Top right.
Top right.
Ah, perfect. Why does it say a 40? It says I have 40.
Should be 10. Here, I'll fix that. Okay, so you're at 25, so just take 3 off there.
I'm 22.
He's cake. Ma, he's got HP to spare. Okay.
Yeah.
So they put you out, Ravolt. So you're burned, but the divine authority... You burned yourself before, right?
Yeah.
And but it was just your arms, your hands. But you were, like, scarred, and you had to wrap them up for a few days.
Right, I'm a mummy man now.
That didn't happen this time.
Oh, cool.
This time when it burns, your divine authority, it still hurts. You feel like your hands and your legs are burnt, but you can still use them, and you have to fight through the pain. But underneath, it looks like the skin has, like, charred away. And underneath there is, like, instead of where muscle would be that's exposed by your burnt-away skin, there is a stone. A sort of pearlescent marble, almost.
Marble man.
Yeah. It still hurts. And as your skin can peel away, it can peel away still, right? Like, I think they pull away the blanket, and a piece of it is, like, stuck, and Mog doesn't think about it real quick, and he whips it, and there's, like, this ribbon of flesh that comes off, and you let out a scream. But underneath there, like, sort of smeared in blood that sort of washes away, he's uncovered. As it strips away flesh, there's more marble.
Yeah. So it's, like... solid white, like it feels like hard, like marble.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Kind of gross, but alright.
So that's your divine authority, is like, you know, look at my horrible nightmare hands made of stone.
Yeah, like if I feel my like chest and stuff, does it feel the same, like where it's like a layer of skin over rock or something?
Yeah, it feels hard.
Yeah, because I imagine, like, yeah, I put oil on my thing, but, like, the fire, I think, would have rode up me.
You like,
yeah,
touching yourself, and you don't feel, like, individual ribs. You feel just, like, a solid surface.
Neat.
And a horrible lot of pain.
Yeah. And a lot of pain. Your vows shall be valor.
All right.
Thou shalt not forbid, or thou shalt not suffer an evil creature to live.
Mm-hmm.
Standard. And it shall be... hospitality. You must protect those in need. All of them.
Okay.
And honor.
And honor. Okay. Cool. Yeah.
Okay.
Alrighty.
Shall we head to the governor then?
Sure. I want to know, like, is Hagor, like, what the fuck? Like, is he scared or weirded out or anything?
Mog is just like, Right. This guy took a nap and came back freaking out. This guy lights himself on fire. Are we going on a quest? A vision?
Quite literally. Vision quest? Quite literally, I'm going on a quest.
They ask others around you if he's going to be okay. What is he doing? But they definitely see the marble beneath your flesh. Everyone does. And that you were inciting holy prayers. I think everybody who's not like your hirelings or whatever, keep a distance from you now. as far as the NPCs are concerned, anyway.
Right. Okay.
But yeah, they don't really know what to do with it, but things need to happen. And Hagor is driven. And once he's found out, like, he can walk, he can do whatever, as long as you can talk for him, he says, okay. And he rounds you all up eventually and says, let's go.
Cool.
Can I prepare my spells?
This is the other way I'll survive a horrible fire, Chris. I'm going to keep doing this until I qualify.
Yeah. If you are someone who prepares spells, then do so now. But you make your way through the streets, and you're kind of a sizable group, but the cloaked figures, they hide amongst you, basically. You cut kind of a wide swath in the streets, so they're moving around with you. They're still cloaked and stuff, but they're hiding behind the fact that you are escorting Elman. But they put you guys to lead the charge. They say, you guys, you know, deliver him to the gates and we'll step in when it's our time. They're basically, banking on the goodwill toward you.
Okay.
So are you taking the lead here, Ravolt?
Yeah, I think so. Like, I have, like, you know, what's his, you know, Elman is handcuffed. I didn't put them behind his back because, like, I mean, it didn't matter. Like, I knew he could just get out of them. I have, like, a hand on his, like, shirt or something as I'm, like, walking, like, him forward. And if we get to the gate or whatever, just, I apologize, gentlemen, but we have no time for niceties. We must speak with the Duke immediately. And I kind of, like, gesture. There's much evil afoot, and, well, I'm sure he'd like to speak with this one. And I kind of, like, hold up, and, like, maybe, well, I'm sure it would have gotten wet, but I have, like, the wet, like, wanted poster with his name on it, or his face on it, like, the drawing.
Yeah, and I wink at them. I try to make the face in the poster.
Do the finger guns.
Yeah.
Finger guns. Yeah, I think they recognize you. They know who you are. They know the orders. They definitely recognize Elman.
Of course they do. Who would?
And they say, they bring you in. They kind of don't say anything. And they bring everybody in, all in one group. And they sort of let out a, I think one of them has a horn, right? And, like, sort of blows the horn. And some other soldiers come up. So the warriors, the knights of, Konbald, most of them were killed, right? We've gone over that a couple times, a few months ago. But in the streets, he has the Sunhawks basically working as the town guard. But on his estate, at his, like, governor's manse, that's the remainder of his soldiers. His men. are basically his protectors, and there are a lot more soldiers than normal at all times than would have been previously. You understand what I mean? There are fewer soldiers overall than normal, but on his compound, there are more because he's got everybody there. You know, like, the Sunhawks are doing all the outriding outside of town, everything. So you're basically flanked by... At first, before you even get in the door, you're flanked by five soldiers. And they've got big spears, right? And pretty heavy armor. And... They gather you... Do they take you inside? No. They bring you... They leave you outside. They gather you in front of the house, basically. There's too many of you to, like, file in. Here we go. And one of them, you know, goes inside, and by the time the Duke comes, they don't say anything to you. They don't speak to you. They're just standing there, basically guarding you and watching all of you.
Can I start whistling a tune while we wait?
Yeah. And when the Duke comes back out, he's got five soldiers behind him. So now you're basically surrounded by like 10, 11 soldiers. Spears, heavy armor. And the Duke, I think he's got a handkerchief in his hand, and he's, like, wiping them, right? It's, like, evening, so he was having dinner or whatever, and he's just come walking out. He's still dressed rather well, and he's sort of, like, wiping crumbs away. And, yeah, he steps out onto the porch, basically. There's, like, four or five steps that go up to his house, and there's like a landing up there, and he's standing up there. You know, he's the Duke, so he's standing at the top step while you all are gathered at the bottom to kind of like tower over you and survey you, basically. And he says, okay, so you found him.
Yes, though not without much difficulty and aid. I look back at our cloaked figures. Yeah.
So he just like, I think he hands the handkerchief off to like the side, and the guard like grabs it.
Yeah.
And he says, you've brought me more.
I fold up a hand. I found no thieves' guild, but rather a race of people who are in need of aid. They are the ones who caught this one.
He says, a race?
And a nod. I know not the proper name. Just, or I cannot pronounce it, but the dwarves had a name.
Ingo the... Batrani?
do you spout up Mog and give them the name?
I'll just... Ingo Batrani.
yeah, and put a hand on his shirt. The Ingo Batrani.
He says, what is this? You found people beneath beggars?
Certainly not. And I look back at Hagor, and I kind of, like, gesture him, like, forward, like, you know, at his hood, you know?
Yeah, he comes walking forward, and he's about to say something, and the Duke says, don't bother. And he, like, snaps and, like, waves a hand at one of the guards who pulls out a bag, right? And it's the bag you found, Revel. And he takes this bag of coins you found. And he says, no, We've intercepted you already. These are the ones you are after. Now you are their friends.
There are no thieves.
He says the needy don't usually carry such hefty bags.
They need not money, they need soldiers. The Skinner, the undead. They plague your minds, they plague their homes.
He pulls out a coin, and I think Hagor, he says, you will see reason.
Quite the parlay tactic. Right
there. And the Duke says, I think I've seen the reason already. And he reaches into the bag and grabs out a few coins. And he says, you didn't think that maybe they could be working for him already. You bring them to my doorstep.
Yeah, I've had a hand on Elman. I think I let that go. I take a step forward, right? Maybe the guard's what the fuck? And I hold up, I have my hands exposed. I kind of hold them up and I've prayed to the hero god Rickard. These people here, they are not evil. No, they are like us, and they need help.
So, I think he stops, and he looks at your arms and your hands, and he gets a, horrified look on his face, right?
Yeah.
I think it's your hands almost look like skeletal, right? Because of the marble and the burnt away flesh. So at first he's like, oh my god. And he starts to take a step back. And Elman. Hagor, he now leans over close to you, and he says, sometimes we flip a coin for luck.
And I flip the coin, I guess.
So you go to flip the coin, and you hear him, whisper some word. Some chain of words. And the coin, shoots up from your finger. You didn't even mean to flip it that hard, but it launches up, and you all can hear a high-pitched ringing sound now. Emanating from the coin as it's, spinning and flashing. And it only takes a moment, but as it gets higher and higher and your ears feel like they're gonna burst, there's a light, or it's like a light or an emptiness that opens up in the coin, and coming running out of it, as if from nowhere, are more soldiers.
Go Batrani?
Yeah. A number of soldiers,
like 2d8.
No.
Oh, okay.
But it is 20 or 30.
Jeez.
Okay.
Most of them have big pikes. But they just come out of the coin, and they're led by a couple of soldiers in heavier armor. and they're holding their blades out. And at the back of them, Betlick, you see a face you've seen before.
Oh no.
A face you've consulted before. Also hooded. And bearing a sword. Walks out of the darkness. And the Duke goes running, y'all. He turns to flee. Okay.
No. I crack my knuckles, and I'm gonna cast Hold Person on that motherfucker.
Okay. all right, do it.
Yeah.
What are we doing here? What's going on?
Well, we were evil the whole time.
He turns around and he feels a pressure holding him by the neck.
Yeah.
And he's immobilized.
So the Duke, like, stops as he tries to turn, right? And then he can't move. But his soldiers do come charging. Now, there's 10 of them and, like, 20 or 30 of these other guys, and they're going to engage in a fight.
Sure.
What are you guys doing?
Maybe you're about to kill myself. So I 10 coming down this way, and I guess I got 30 behind me. I'm but one man, but I bellow as loud as I can. I just yell halt. And I'm trying again, like, do my weird, like, mark of divine authority thing. I'm trying to do I am the law. I'm telling them everyone to stop.
Mog is gonna back away.
Yeah, get away from me.
Okay. Go ahead, Revolt, and let's roll that.
Okay. I'm just gonna do the fool thing, I guess. I guess I'm gonna do the fool thing. How did I fail that? Okay, the third roll today. I've rolled 4 times today. 3 of them are failures. Anyway,
Do you only have +1 cha?
I do. I'm built for intelligence. Anyway,
I'm built for intelligence. Why?
And you roll minimum 1.
Every time.
I'm a detective. So, sure. I guess, like, the fool thing is, like, I guess, again, like, it's kind of like I move quickly and I try to, like, you know, I shoot my hands out, all that stuff. And I guess, like, whatever skin is there, it tears.
How?
It tears in the pressure. And I sort of, like, keel over and, like, groan and stuff. So my sort of shouting of Hall turns into, like, a scream of horrible pain. Plume fail this again. Okay, whatever.
So you're going to speak, and this hooded figure,
I forgot that I have Charming and Open. Whatever.
Oh.
This hooded figure, You start to say something and then you, like, crumble, and then you look up and you lock eyes with him, and his eyes are glowing also, sort of that pale color. And just at the edge of his lips, he's standing across from you, and you can already hear the screaming and the running, but you can hear him as if he's whispering in your ear, and he just whispers the word, sleep. And Ravel kind of, like, buckles. You feel the pain sort of melt away from you, and he just sort of, like, rests on the ground. Let's take a break.
I've rolled 5 out of 6 failures today.
You're gonna, like, level up.
Yeah, let's take 5 minutes, so y'all can think about what's about to go down.
I don't understand. Understand?
I don't even know what I did, but, you know, it's cool.
Thank you.